Welcome to 3-week workshop on programming in C++. In this video, I'm going to explain the concept of two-dimensional array. In the last video, we had a discussion on basic concepts and the working principle of one-dimensional array. In this video, I'm going to explain how the two-dimensional array are represented and how we can access it. So normally in a two-dimensional array means that it consists of two subscripts, and then normally it will be represented in the form of matrix format, rows and columns. So normally this matrix representations can be used in image processing applications and mathematical calculations. So the syntax for defining a two-dimensional array is array name, followed by the two square bracket. The first square bracket indicates a row size, and the next square bracket indicates the column size. So normally if you are accessing the matrix element by using row index and as well as the column index, every index starts with a zero. So then normally if you are processing all the elements of a matrix, we have to prefer to use one nested looping concept for accessing element. So first of all, we know how to declare. So first of all, we must know how the memory is organized for this. So just a minute, I can change this patterns. I'll go to one simple example. Okay, so for example, I'm going to define here I'm going to define as integer AR5 three elements. So totally there are 15 elements. It is a 15 elements we are going to store, because 5 into 3, 15 elements. So then the total amount of memory is 15 into 2, so that the total is 30 bytes will be allocated for this. So I need to allocate the 30 bytes first. Totally the 30 bytes are allocated. The 30 bytes are allocated. So it will be in a 2 bytes for a 1 value. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So here, for one row, it consists of three columns. One row. Three columns, that is three values. So the three value means it is a 6 bytes. 6 bytes consist of one row, so that it will be considered as row one. One row, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I will repeat once again. This is a row 0 because the index starts with row 0. And this row, it is 1. This is 2, 3, and 4. So here, that means that this is for index, this is for column. So I'm going to indicate it is a column 0, column 1, and column 2. Again, column 0. This is column 0, column 1, and column 2 in row 0. So this is the way we are representing a matrix. So that if you want, for example, I'm going to say this is a 20, 20, 30, 40. So initially all the values are located as 0, means once if you are not initialized, the default values in the matrix is 0 in both C and C++. So initially it will be 0. So I am changing the value as 20, 20 means a 20, 10 for a column 1. For this is a row 1. Just I am going to easy to understand. Just I can make a box for easy understanding. This is only for understanding purpose. So that so my column value is so I'm going to the values are representer. So I'm going to enter like a 6, 7, 8, 9. So like that I can store. Okay, so if you want to know access the value of this A, 8, first of all, I must know my array name. Array name is A. Now, first of all, you followed, I mean, again, it followed with the row index. So that row number 2, so 2, then followed by, I want to access 8 so that my column number is 0, so that I can use AR20. So, but again, the memory is continuous. For easy understanding, I'm going to give a continuous value start from 1. I'm going to give only integer value. I'm not going to represent for fractional. Sorry, I'm not going to represent in hexadecimal format. For easy understanding, I'm going to give in the form of continuous value. Otherwise, I can go with no problem. So A, B, C, D, E, F, then 1, 1, 12. Again, now 9, then 1A, 1B, 1C, 1D, and 1E. So this is the address. So if you want to know, so you know that the starting address is 1. So that even always the starting address means always is told the address of 0. For example, if I want to access A of 20, the formula for calculation of address is starting address of array, starting address of matrix plus row size into column size. Means that a maximum column size, it means that it is a maximum column size, because we need to skip entire thing so that we need to know about maximum column size. Without column size, we can't able to define your matrix. And the row index, it means that it is a row index into size of your data time. Otherwise, we can type multiply in the later part. So that is called the row index plus column index into multiplied by size of your data type. So this is the formula to calculate an address. So here I'm going to calculate an address. So my starting address of the matrix is a 1 plus my row index is 2. And maximum column size is 3. Just a minute. So my column index is a 0 multiplied with index integer 2. So it display the answer is 13. So you know that the 13 means that it is equivalent to B in hexadecimal. See the address of A of 20. See the address of A of 0. This is row 2 and 0. So that this is the address. D. So it returned D. So like that, we need to calculate that. I mean, always the background that calculation like doing like this. Even during a compilation, while converted into that memory, converted into that machine code, the background task to calculate it based on this logics. So, now I'm going to discuss how to define a two-dimensional matrix. So we know that the matrix will be represented by two-dimensional. So there are two ways we can assign. One is a compile time, another one is a runtime. So you have to write it's a two-dimensional means it's a collection of one-dimensional array. So that you can define one curly braces, for example, 1, 2, 3. So 2, 3, 4. So like that I'm defined. Just I'm defined only the two rows. But here if you are given like this, if two rows and three columns, it's not a problem. No errors. Yeah, yes, here it will be changed. Okay, we'll change it later. So first of all, we can go with how the compiler installation is possible. So here the number of columns are okay, no problem. But if you are trying to remove this column size, this you can check it. There is no error because unknown zero. Always we need to type the column with, but not necessary to define a row with value if you are go with compile time initialization. Means at the time of declaration, if you are trying to initialize, then there is no need to go with row size initialization, not necessary. But in case, but even if you are, I mean, if you are giving more than one value, then surely it makes an error message. Too many initializers. And same way, if you are giving only two values, this you can check in. No problem, the memory is well allocated, but for only for the first zeroth index of the first two, and the one will be assigned to, and the third value will be assigned as a zero. So that when you are going to define a value, that means that number of values in every set cannot cross the maximum limit. If you are cross the maximum limit, show that it is a too many initializers. Next one, I am trying to go with the compile time initialization. If I go with the compile time initialization method, so I told that I prefer to go to one listed looping because rows and columns. I'm going to say that my number of rows is here, it will show an error message. If you are given like that, surely it makes an error message. The row size must be known. So I'm going to give 5. It is a two-dimensional array. So normally, if you are getting a two-dimensional array, so you must know what is the maximum size of row and column. It is the best way to assign row and column. So just you can find the row and column. Means to get the enter. It is called order of the matrix, generally in mathematics format. So now we have to use row and column format. So outer index always indicated for column, sorry, row, and the inner index always indicated for column. There are two index, the first index a row and second index column. We can follow the same just to copy and paste. So 4, I'm going to read it separately and display it so that the row, then I'm going to define a column. So the first index always indicates a row and second index always indicates a column. So now I'm going to compile. And this is undefined. I'm going to compile. And then, so row size, I'm going to give 2, 2. So that I'm going to define 1, 2, 3, 4. It will, based on the logic or what we use, the same logic it will work. But if you want to display in a matrix format, you can use install. You should not use a slash in here inside of the loop because one row can step many number of elements, so that you can use a slash here. Then at the loop, you can use slash and once one row is printed. But same as in C. For example, I'm going to 3, 3. It will be displayed in a matrix format. So this is the way the matrix will be readed and initialized. So that if you want, you can use a calculation. I think you know how to process a calculation in C itself. You can follow the same methodology to do a calculations by using an array. Thank you.